Oh, hi! Caroline here. Have you ever wondered how comic books are made? Well, the first step to making a comic book is to choose a subject that is exciting to you. And can you think of anything more exciting than the sun? Earth's shining star! The center of our solar system, the burning ball of plasma, our source of light and heat. So, let's learn all about this superstar and make a space-tastic comic book. Today we are going to explore our amazing sun. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to describe the structure and rotation of the sun, explain energy production and energy transport in the sun, list examples of solar activity, and compare lunar and solar eclipses. So, let's take a trip into the bright light of our amazing sun! Let's face it. Without the sun's intense energy and warmth, there would be no life on Earth. While there are billions of stars like our sun scattered across the galaxy, the sun is the one that keeps our Earth going round. Our shining star is 864,000 miles in diameter and over 100 times the size of Earth. The temperature of the sun ranges from about 10,000 degrees Fahrenheit on the surface to nearly 27 million degrees Fahrenheit at the center. Made mostly of hydrogen and helium, our sun is literally a big ball of burning layers of gas. Yep. Even though the sun is made of gas, it still has layers and structure. The sun's interior is made up of three layers. The first is the very center, the sun's core. Inside the core, hydrogen atoms are constantly being fused together and becoming helium atoms through a process called nuclear fusion. During this process, some of the mass from the atoms is converted into energy. Nuclear fusion creates very high temperatures and tons of energy inside the sun's core that push their way out to the surface with the help of the other layers. This energy is where the heat and light from the sun that we experience on Earth begins. The next layer of the sun's interior is the radiative zone. It takes the energy from the core over 100,000 years to move through this layer. Energy travels through the radiative zone in a form of energy called electromagnetic radiation. In other words, it travels in waves made of packets of energy called photons that bounce off other particles. And the last layer of the sun's interior is the convection zone. You may have heard of a convection oven that makes sure that the entire oven is the same temperature using fans to circulate the heat. In the same way, convection currents, or currents of heat, continue to move energy in the convection zone outwards and toward the sun's surface. These heated currents expand and eventually move into the sun's atmosphere. The next three layers of the sun are the sun's atmosphere. The first of these layers is the photosphere, the innermost layer that we can observe. Photosphere means sphere of light. This is the layer of the sun from which the Earth receives most of its light and energy. It takes about 8 minutes for sunlight from the photosphere to reach us here on Earth, and when it does, we simply see that light as daytime. The photosphere's appearance is that of bright-colored plasma and darker-colored sunspots. Sunspots are cooler than the rest of the sun's surface and have more magnetic activity. Linking two sunspots are giant loops of plasma called prominences. The way that plasma on the sun's surface behaves led astronomers to realize that the sun, like the Earth and the moon, rotates on its own axis. However, since the sun is made of gas, different parts of it rotate at different speeds. The regions near the center rotate in about 24 days, but near the two poles it takes more than 30 days to complete a rotation. The photosphere is also where solar flares occur. These bursts of fire extend thousands, hundreds of thousands, of miles above the sun's surface. Solar flares make crazy strong energy called electromagnetic radiation, like that made in the radiative zone. Luckily, our Earth's atmosphere protects us from these dangerous flares of energy. Now, let's talk about the layer that keeps most of this energy together inside the sun's atmosphere. The chromosphere, made of magnetic field lines, helps keep all the crazy sun energy intact. The chromosphere emits a reddish glow, but it can only be seen during a total solar eclipse. We'll talk more about eclipses in just a minute. Like the chromosphere, the corona, the last outermost layer of the sun, can also be seen only during a solar eclipse. During an eclipse, the corona will appear as white streams of light shooting out into space. When the 3.5 million degree Fahrenheit temperatures in the sun's corona spread away from the sun and begin to cool, these charged particles become solar wind, shooting out from the sun's corona into the universe. Remember when I mentioned that you cannot see the chromosphere and the corona except during a solar eclipse? Well, solar eclipses are amazing phenomena that we get to experience here on Earth. They occur when the moon passes between the Earth and is totally or partially hiding the sun. This means they only happen during a new moon. This alignment doesn't last long, though. During the longest solar eclipses, the sun is only completely covered up by the moon for up to about 7.5 minutes. And the coolest part is that, since the sun's light is blocked, that means it gets dark in the middle of the day. Of course, to be able to view this astronomical phenomenon, you have to wear special protective safety glasses. It is still the sun, after all. A solar eclipse, especially a total one, can be seen from only a certain part of Earth that aligns with the moon and sun just right. On the other hand, a lunar eclipse, or an eclipse of the moon, can be seen from anywhere that the moon is currently visible. A lunar eclipse happens when the Earth blocks sunlight from reflecting off of the moon. Essentially, it's when the Earth's shadow falls across the moon. This kind of eclipse can only occur during a full moon. That's because a full moon is the only time that the Earth is directly between the moon and the sun. You don't need special glasses for this one, just permission to stay up late and watch the night sky. What do you think? Will the sun make a great comic book? I may need to add some other characters too, like the Earth and Venus. We have spun all the way to the end of today's lesson. We learned that the sun has layers within and around it, and energy moves through the sun's layers before eventually reaching Earth. Also, the sun rotates on its axis while the Earth revolves around it. And finally, the Earth's movement around the sun can sometimes result in us seeing amazing eclipses. Don't forget to check out the engaging games and thought-provoking resources related to this lesson. And always remember, you are out of this world!